Hi friends, so in this video we are gonna see a concept of logarithm of complex number. Now we have seen how to find logarithm of real number, but we don't know how to find the logarithm of complex number. So as we have learned about complex number in previous topics, today we are gonna see how exactly we can find out the logarithm of complex number. So to understand this concept, I am assuming one complex number z equal to x plus iy. Now here I am representing the number in Cartesian form, and the polar form of this number is r into cos theta plus I sin theta, as we all know, and the exponential form is r into e raised to I theta. Now to find out the logarithm, I'll take log on both sides. So left hand side will become log of z equal to, now on right hand side I have three forms of complex number, where one is Cartesian, other is polar, and the third one is exponential. And to find out the log, we will use the exponential form of complex number. So log of z is nothing but log of x plus iy, and to find the log, I'll basically use the form r e raised to I theta, because the exponential form can work with logarithm and we can get the formula very easily. So here this r and e are multiplying each other, so here I'll be using a formula of logarithm, that is log a into b. So this will become log of r plus log of e raised to I theta. Now log of r will remain as it is, whereas this log and e will be cancelled since the base of this log is e, and we will get I theta over here. So it means the formula for log of x plus iy is equal to log of r plus I theta. But now here we also have to find out the value of r and theta. So we have seen in the complex number that r is nothing but modulus, and it is represented by the formula root of x square plus y square. Similarly, this theta is called as amplitude, which is represented by the formula tan inverse of y by x. So here at r, I'll substitute this value root of x square plus y square, and at theta, I'll substitute the value tan inverse of y by x. And hence, I'll get the formula for log of x plus iy as log of root of x square plus y square plus I tan inverse of y by x. Now here, we can also take this power, or I'll say this root, outside the log. So this root is nothing but raised to half. So x square plus y square raised to half, and I tan inverse y by x as it is. So after taking this half here, so this will become half log of x square plus y square plus I tan inverse of y by x. So basically here I am using the formula log of a raised to b, and this will become b log a, and hence I am taking this half here ahead of this log. So these are two formulas which we can use to find out the log of complex number. Now as we have seen how to find out the log of complex number, this we call it as principal value of logarithm. Now if we want to find out the general value of log x plus iy, then it is basically denoted by capital L. Now this value, that is log of x plus iy, is called as principal value of log of x plus iy. But if I want to find out the general value of the log of x plus iy, then basically it is denoted by capital L. So this will become log of x plus iy, you can see here that I am representing L by capital L. And to get the general value, we all know that we have to add 2n pi in theta. So the general value will be half log x square plus y square, and in theta I will add 2n pi. So that will become I into 2n pi plus tan inverse of y by x. And this is nothing but the formula to find out the general value of logarithm. Now these two formulas will be useful to find out the value of some numericals. So let's see the first numerical. So here we have to show that log of minus log I is equal to log pi by 2 minus I pi by 2. Now you can see the term inside the bracket is the logarithm of a complex number. So let's start with that. So log of I. So here log of I, if I'll compare it with x plus iy, then that will become log of 0 plus I. And here I can say that x is 0 and y is equal to 1. Now if we'll use the formula of logarithm, then log of I is given by 1 by 2 log of x square plus y square, so 0 square plus 1 square, plus I tan inverse of y by x, so y is 1 and x is 0. So hence we'll get 1 by 2 as it is, log of 1 is 0, plus I, here we'll get tan inverse of infinity, and we'll get the value for log of I equal to I pi by 2, because tan inverse of infinity is pi by 2 and this term is 0. Now we'll use this value in the LHS. So therefore this log of minus log I will become log of minus I pi by 2. Now here once again we have to find out the log of complex number. So this will become 1 by 2 log of x square, that is 0 square, plus y square. Here y is minus pi by 2. So minus pi by 2 the whole square, plus I tan inverse of y by x. So minus pi by 2 by 0. Now if we'll find this, then we'll get half square of pi by 2 is pi square by 4. So here we'll get log of pi square by 4. And I, now we all know that anything upon 0 is infinity. Now since numerator is negative, we'll get tan inverse of negative infinity in the bracket. Now this half we can take it in the power, and that will become the root, and hence we will get log of root of this pi square by 4, which is nothing but pi by 2. And this tan inverse of minus infinity is nothing but minus tan inverse of infinity. And here we can substitute the answer for tan inverse of infinity as pi by 2. So we'll get the final value as log of pi by 2 minus I pi by 2. And this is the value of log minus log I which is being asked. Thank you.